Once you have installed Kurzweil and it is ready for use, go ahead and open the program up. Once you open Kurzweil up, this is what it's going to look like. It's always going to show you a tip of the day. They change quite frequently, so give them a little read because sometimes they come out with new features and you can go ahead and take a look and give it a try. You can exit out of that at any time. When you want to open a blank document, you're going to go to the red menu here, which is the reading menu. If you ever want to close a menu because you're not using it, for example, you're not going to be using the writing menu, you can just click on the blue icon and it will close down. Same with the study skills menu, you can give that a close as well. So I'm just going to give your attention to the top two menus here. To open a blank document, just click on the new file and it's going to go ahead and open a document for you. If you want to open one of your textbooks, for example, just go to the open file and grab a document that you might use. So, for example, I'm just going to open our accessible format agreement, which most of you probably have signed if you're using the reading software anyway. So double click on that, and it's just going to render into a Kurzweil file, and then it's going to be ready for use. If you want to see the whole screen at once, you could minimize it down here. You could also bring down the menu, and you can pick what size you want to view the file at. You can also use your little scroll tool on your mouse, and it will do the same thing once it's in this selected area here. If you want to save a file, you can click on the Save button, and it will pop up your File Explorer here. You can go to Desktop, and then you can save it to whatever you'd like. If you have files on your desktop possibly that you want to save it in, such as your school files, go ahead and select the folder that you'd like to put it in, and then hit save. If you want to read through the document, you can put your cursor anywhere you'd like, highlight what you want read, or just put your cursor at the front and hit play. When you hit play, it's going to start reading through the document. If you want to look up the definition of a word, you can double click on a word and then hit the definition tool. Same for synonym, the pronounce tool, syllables, and for spell. You can also turn the voice on and off, possibly if you're going to be writing something in Kurzweil. You might want to turn it off so it's not reading all the words for you. If you'd like to read online for the web, you can hit the web tool here. It will open in Firefox automatically and ask you to install the plugin. Once you do that, you can hit OK and read stuff on Firefox only. To adjust your voice, you can go here and you can pick any of the voices you would like to use. Continuous reading is usually the setting I keep it on. If you want to have it highlight while it's reading through a word, or possibly a phrase, a line, a sentence, paragraph, heading, or highlight. I keep it on sentence, so if I want the whole thing to be reading back, it's just going to highlight at each sentence at a time. This is the pace of your voice that it's going to be reading back, and here is where the pages of your document exist. If you have a book that's, say, about 250 pages, and you want to go halfway through the book, say to 125, you can type in 125 here, like so. Since my page only has one page, I'm just going to keep it on page one. If you have any questions about this software and you'd like to learn how to utilize it more, please book an appointment with your assistive technologist.